Should I go full energetic mode or should I keep it calm?
So guys, wait, 11k, that's the money.
Oh, okay.
Dude, congrats.
Well, a little bit. I'm lucky. I pre-flop all in kings against Ace King and Knights. Was the last one.
Yeah.
Anyway, you?
I bust the main in four hands on day two, and then I am doing really well in the 25k at the moment.
Okay, good luck.
Yeah, thanks, dude.
Keep fingers.
See ya. So guys, 500,000 chips, I called it. I said this bullet of this tournament is the one we're going all the way on dinner break right now, and the blinds are about to be 8K, 16K, which puts us at a healthy 31 big blinds. If I am doing my math, no, wait, that's not right. No, that is right. So right. And I've had some pretty damn fun spots, man. As soon as I got moved onto that last table, stuff was going downhill instantly. I think the first hand or second hand I play, I'm in the big blind. I get kings, someone shoves ahead of me. They have ace queen, queen on the flop, queen on the river. Oh, I'll double that guy up, who cares? And then I lost a couple more hands, meditated, recuperated, and we managed to bluff our way for most of it, actually. There was one fun one we had where we started with, I think, 25 bigs. We limp blind versus blind with jack 10 suited. We'd folded the last blind, so he knows we're not 100% there against a bigger stack. He is a reg. I haven't met him before. He seems pretty competent, but I've got very good reasoning. So he raises to 3.5x. We call. It's ace-6-3, one of our suit. We're like, balls, boys. We check, and he checks back, which is pretty strange. It feels just like he might have like a bottom pair type hand. He might have a trappy ace. He might have pocket aces, maybe. He might have pocket kings, queens, jacks, those kind of hands. So we're not particularly interested. Sorry, it was ace. Yeah, it was like ace seven deuce, and then it was like turn nine, giving us a flush draw and a gut shot. We snap check. Why do we snap check? Because I wouldn't be betting pretty much any of my hands here. I just can't have ace-x. They all limp shove pre. Or at least he will think that. That might not necessarily be true based on if I have a read that is strong, things like that. But you have to think about your perceived range more than your actual range in these kind of situations. So, well, at least that's my opinion. So we snap check the turn because we know we're not going to be betting. We might have some disguises, some, if we hit our flush on the river or look a lot less like we have a flush because we snap check the turn. There are most of our flush draws, it looks like, I believe, would consider betting. And he checks back again. So now it's feeling like pocket kings kind of hands. River is a, so it's like a seven, deuce, nine, eight. No, not eight, sorry, six. Six, so we have nothing. We snap check. He bets 16K. Maybe it was 16K, maybe it was 22K, something like that, into a pot of like 80 or 90. We snap make it 75K. We get the tank fold. Why do we snap make it 75K? Because I think that we do have a bunch of value hands there, and we do have a bunch of two pairs. Maybe he does think we can have an ace, stuff like that. But it also looks like a spot, I believe, that people, and he seemed like quite an exploitative player, judging by a few of the hands he played. It seemed like a spot where it doesn't look like people are going to take that bluff because we don't have that many value hands. And the hands that snap check down are usually showdown value hands. And what does that mean? Well, if we had a showdown value hand and we had like, I don't know, like a seven, if there was, yeah, like a seven, then I believe that he would think that we would consider calling instead of snap raising. I'm actually really, really happy with that play. I know it's quite a relatively simple hand, but it's just one of those things where you get of playing hours and hours and hours and hours of online poker and live poker, where you start to feel the kind of situations where a specific type of player would fold. I'm pretty sure he folded like kings or queens or something along those lines. So a new recreational player with a huge stack sits down at the table. He opens cutoff. He looks quite strong, and we defend king jack suited in the big blind. Stack size is not super relevant for a deck 30 bigs. It comes 6-5-4, I think. 6-5-4, two hearts. We have no hearts. We tank check, and I think this is pretty important when you're against recreational players to tank check if you want them to check back on these kind of boards. It just shows that you're interested, and it's just a little trick that I've figured out. Seems to work a treat. So then the turn is, let's say, a 9, bring two flush draws. This isn't exactly it. It's something along these lines, and I bet, like a third, he calls. At this point, I'm putting him on ace high. And the river's like a deuce, bringing in one of the backdoor flush, I think. And I bet half pot. And got a tank fold from ace high. So I was right about him having ace high, but the fact that he tanked for so long is kind of scary. I get hero called by so many recreational players. They just take one look at me and they're just like, this dumb kid. Less so, I think, when I've stopped dressing like a hippie, which is handy. And hopefully in the future tournaments, I'll have my suits, which are being cleaned right now, my shirts. So I'll instantly get 1,000 times more fold equity. Also, there's 26 people left. We are 9 from the money, so 17 people get paid. We're in for 2 bullets, so the min cash would still be a loss for the day, so we're not looking at that. In fact, we're in quite a lot of makeup because despite winning that 50K for like 1.4 million, we then bust 4 bullets of the 100K and then another 2 in the other 100K, and we cashed for the main event for like 100 and something anyway, so it's not terrible. But we're looking at first and second place to clear the makeup, I think. So first place is 712K, which would be a nice tidy profit for the last few months. And that's where we have our eyes on.
Eyes on the prize.
Eyes on the prize, boys.
See you next break.
Gary, where do you think I'm going to come? Guns ahead, where do you think I'm going to come?
I think you make a card table.
Dude, thanks.
Yeah, I don't know what you're
I think about. I'm doomed if you guys already make the content.
Fields are still looking pretty deep. It's a good thing about the turbos.
This
discussion is a lot easier for 19. Next hour or so, and then we don't need to get in all this malarkey.
Until the break, you can make an agreement, yeah?
Everyone in accordance, speak up if no.
never stalled.
Yeah, I've never stalled either, but. So the boat was being really fun, but also mildly telling, just because there have been a couple of stallers on the table.